Hey guys, how's it going? It's a pocket. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a Windows 7 all the way up to the latest version of Windows bootable USB flash drive. So let's get started. I remember one or so years ago, I made a very similar video, but it was absolutely crap. I think I forgot to edit it properly and there were massive mistakes which I had to take it down. So in this video, I will add more details and a lot more things that you need to know in order to do it properly and correctly. Okay, so straight to the video. So first of all, you need to have an 8 GB of USB flash drive. You may use an SD card instead, but it has to be, again, at least 8 GB of storage. But if you want to use an SD card, you must have a USB adapter in order for this method to work. Otherwise, it's probably not going to work for you. In my case, I'm using a USB flash drive of 64 GB of storage. After that, you need to plug your USB onto your computer, and once your computer recognizes your USB stick, you need to navigate to your browser and navigate to www.paragon/software.com and download NTFS for Mac 15. This will allow us to format our USB flash drive into exFAT, because that way is going to be accessible on both of Mac and Windows computers. So once you have downloaded, make sure to install it and then reboot your computer. After that, you're ready to format your USB flash drive. So next, navigate to Disk Utility and then select your USB flash drive, in my case is called WinInstall, and click on Erase. And then name it as you wish, in my case I'm going to name it Windows 10. And then on Format, select exFAT. Also, if you have another option here named Scheme, select Bootmaster and then click Erase and then simply hit Done. And then you need to navigate to your browser and navigate to this official website of Microsoft where you can download the Windows 10 disk image. If you want to download Windows 7, then you need to look for another source to download Windows 7 or 8 or 8.1 from Microsoft. But in this video, I'm going to do a Windows 10 installation instead because the latest version of Windows. Okay, so then you need to click on this option and then you need to select Windows 10 and then you need to click on Confirm. Next, select a language and I always choose English International, but it's up to you if you want to choose another language of your choice. Click on Confirm. And lastly, you need to select either 64-bit or 32-bit Windows 10. Now, computers those days are all 64-bit. But if you're planning to install Windows 10 on a computer which is manufactured on 2007 or 2006 or 2008, probably it's going to use 32-bit. Probably it doesn't support 64-bit, but only 32-bit, so you need to install 32-bit instead. But if you're planning to install Windows 10 on a modern computer, then 64-bit is your best choice. But other than that, it's entirely up to you. After you decide which one of those you're gonna download, you need to wait because it's 4 GB and you need to wait until it's downloaded. Okay, so now you need to go to the search bar and type Bootcamp Assistant. Now, I usually avoid using Bootcamp Assistant, but I found that there are other methods as well to install Windows 10 on a USB disk, but unfortunately, it's going to be fiddly and it's probably not going to work for anyone. So instead, I will try to keep things as simple as possible for this video. So then you need to click on continue. Now, if you have an older machine, you may not have this first option, and this is the worst thing because this first option is essential. Now, if you would like to learn how to fix this and how to add this option, be sure to check the link in the description. So okay, so once you're ready, then you need to deselect this option and then click on continue. Now as you can see, the destination disk is already selected, but please be sure that this is the correct USB flash drive that you're going to install Windows 10 on. So here where it says ISO image, you need to click on choose, then navigate to where the ISO file is. In my case, it's on my folder ISO files. I'm gonna select this one, then I click on open. And then I'm going to click on continue. Then I'll continue. And now Windows 10 is going to be installed on your USB flash drive. So you need to sit tight, take a coffee, and wait until this process has been finished. Once it's done, navigate back to your browser and search for Bootcamp Support Software 5.1.5640 and then click on download. After that, simply move your Bootcamp Support Software to your USB flash drive and then simply eject your USB flash drive and then take it and install Windows 10 on any computer you find out there. And that brings to the end of this video. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to hit the like button if you like this video. Drop a comment if you have something to say about this video. Share this video to your friends if you found this video helpful. And as always, don't forget to subscribe if you are a new visitor, because we keep uploading videos like that every single time. Thanks for watching, and as always, I'm going to see you in my next video.